Here we have built the foundation out of big local found rocks and then a layer of gravel so that the moisture won't have a chance to soak in the bags. Now we are starting on a retaining wall where this feature won't be necessary. And we put in a little curve in to increase the strength of the foundation wall. What goes on the bag is number 57, about 3/4 inch size gravel. These boards we call Velcro. Their purpose is to be a transition between the soft bags and the hard precise setting of the door frame, and they will be used around door and window frames. Here we added a reinforcement to the wall.
Tom?
Yes.
Okay. Good. In. Oh, watch out. Yes. Okay, here. Okay, here.
To build the forms, it takes a few basic tools like a framing nail hammer, like a finish nail hammer to take things in place, like a cutoff saw,
like a reciprocating
saw, like a couple of clamps, drill, and of course a lathe. And the slave master.
Here's our friend Peter, excited because you've done a good thing.
We are using the bricks with a rope around them and clips attached to simplify the holding down of the barbed wire. We have added lots of rebar in crucial areas to stiffen up the structure. Extra pipes in the wall may be used for future expansion projects. We have added a 2-inch pipe for a center post, making it easy to keep it nice and round, exactly 6 feet from the center. Here Jacques is explaining to the workers that the bags should not be as laid down here, flat, but they have to be in an angle, increasingly forming the Roman arch. In order to shape the bag in the proper triangular shape, we have built a box allowing us to have about a 4-inch thickness at the bottom and an 8-inch thickness at the top of the bags that now are used to create this Roman arch above the windows. Proper compression has to be done in a sideways angle, which is a little bit difficult on the workmen and the human anatomy, but that's how it goes. On the ladder you notice the box we use for shaping the bags and its triangular shape.
About just over 3 weeks worth of work, excluding, well, including this wall here. The mastermind.
For the sixth time, we had to replace the temper So the lesson learned is that we need to buy extras and have tools to repair the ones that we bring.
The stick gets shorter and shorter.
That's how it is.
Buckets of the fill material.
Alright, we're gonna mix up the dirt. But one part roadbound, then one part dirt with a good clay content, and all the big rocks have to be thrown out.
In between each layer of bags are a couple of rows of barbed wire that grip and dig into each bag. And you end up using that for support. That keeps the bags in place. Oh shoot!
We'll see what it does when it
I wasn't even recording any of that.
Yeah, I think it's doing that. Yeah, it's been like that for a while. That one's so short because it's already broken.
These are the air intake pipes. A sock protects them from the entering of mice and insects. From here on, the pipes go underneath the wall, several times back and forth, come out in the bucket you see in the distance in the rear. This bucket is the air distribution center, and you see a white pipe coming out to the right, which then leads to the next bucket that is within the range of the foundation.
These two pipes are air intakes that will provide an air conditioning system to the building. They will be connected to a small house that will be put here about 3 by 3 by 3 feet, just enough to get above snow level, be screened in, keep snakes and varmints out, and allow for surface temperature air to enter these two pipes. Then these two pipes go about 40 feet back and forth 3 times till they come out of the bucket over there, which acts as a distribution box. In this bucket distribution box, we have the two pipes that we saw on the other end coming in. We still have a sock on the end which keeps insects, etc. out, but they will be eventually cut. Now we are in the building, and the temperature out of the little distribution box is 73 degrees, with an outside temperature of estimated 88 degrees. This pipe comes out of a second air conditioning system.
Here's the outside of this pipe, and it goes into the ground. Then we have sprayed some insulating foam on top of the surface so that the ground temperature doesn't affect things too much. Underneath the edge of the wall, the pipe goes to an intake into the wall, and behind the wall we have laid several layers of 4-inch PVC, 4-inch pipe, not PVC, but drainage pipe, and here it comes to the future distribution box, and right now it's just lying on the ground. We have installed a couple of wires inside the walls that are connected to the barbed wire, so that eventually if we want to put a corb on the outside, we can install a chicken wire, hardware mesh, something to hold the corb and attach things nice and solid. We have also some kind of a natural fiber rope, but we don't trust it to be strong enough for that, so pretty much discontinue trusting it and just have a few wires here and there. And the corb will eventually cover the building so it is prettier and doesn't require paint anymore.
You can see first the window. We put the plastic in there already on top. This is the bigger window with Catherine behind. Also the plastic on the top is there, the plexiglass. We're looking at all the way around.
And here we are discovering a big problem. The top bag hasn't been laid right. As a result, the form will have to stay in place. Fortunately, it's built strong enough and remain a permanent part of the structure. Lesson learned. Here you notice the application of more of the barbed wire at the top layers.
Okay, so here we are in full activity. Putting those bags. And actually not doing it exactly the way I told them. I told them to put a whole circle and then pound on them, but they want to pound on them one at a time, so that's what they're doing. So the Ruby's getting up there. And we have the ground crew here, working hard, filling the buckets. Okay, you can see here that all of the void has been filled up with foam.
Here Tino had to exchange a bag because we tried to support bags by double bagging them and it was sliding terribly. So we just learned you have to... Double bagging is not an option to deal with low quality bags.
August 3rd, 2011. The men have been here since 7 o'clock this morning.
The building is nearly done. The last few buckets are to be brought up higher and higher. And now you can see the whole picture. From the inside,
okay, you can see the booby is completed, and you have now Peter that is blowing the air.
So we painted it last couple of days. Since the final corb layer will take some time before it gets there. We have windows in, doors in. We are working on the last little reinforcements over the windowsills, a little bit of static. But all in all, successful, beautiful.